What makes servo motors so special? And why are servo motors not used for electric vehicles, for example? Hello, friends of electrical motors. In this video, I will tell you everything that you need to know about servo motors. So for which application servo motors are used and which types of electrical motors are used for servo motors. Of course, I will show you what components a servo motor consists of and what is so special about servo motors. So let's get started. Servo motors are used, for example, for production machines, industrial robots, and CNC machine tools. All these applications are characterized by the fact that the motion are executed highly dynamically. This is important because it allows workpieces or products to be manufactured fast or moved from point A to point B quicker. Servo motors are also used because of their high accuracy of controlling the position and the speed. Because the accuracy of the position and the speed has a direct influence on the quality of the machining of the workpiece. For example, if the speed changes significantly during the machining, then the surface of the end product will not be nice and smooth. Servo motors are AC motors, so they can be induction motors but also synchronous motors. Usually synchronous motors with permanent magnets are used. Compared to induction motors, these motors can generate a higher torque in the lower speed range with the same size. Due to the higher torque, for example, a robot can move a package from point A to point B faster. A servo motor is always a part of an electric servo drive system, which consists of a motor, an inverter, and a position sensor. The inverter is also often called power electronics, servo controller, or simply controller. The task of the inverter is to control the cone, the speed and the position of the servo motor. In order to control the position and the speed very precisely, the position sensor have a high accuracy or resolution. In comparison, electric motors for fans or water pumps only have Hall sensors or even operate sensorless. The sensors used for electric car motors are also less accurate. Often the drive system consists of a gearbox to increase the torque or to turn a rotational movement into a linear movement. What is the difference between a servo motor and a motor for a water pump or a motor for an electric car? In order to be able to control the speed and the position well, a high torque accuracy is required. This is best achieved with external magnets on the rotor. Such motor called SPM-SM. Surface permanent magnet synchronous motors. The disadvantage of an SPM-SM is that it's very difficult to weaken the magnets on the rotor, which causes the torque curve to drop very sharply in the upper speed range. The magnets are also often slightly screwed to each other to make the torque curve smoother and therefore improve the speed synchronization. For a good torque control, many magnet pulls are used on the rotor. So the back EMF has more sinus oscillation per rotation. As a result, the servo motor has more ripple per revolution, but with a smaller amplitude. More magnet poles have the additional advantage to increase the torque density of the electric motor and therefore improving the motor dynamics. Because servo motors usually only run for a very short time and do not run continuously, they only have air or water cooling in a few cases. Additional cooling would increase the power density, but for servo motors, the torque density for fast movements is much more important. This is why servo motors are usually longer in the length. A large diameter would increase the torque, but also increase the inertia of the rotor. And a high mass inertia would, on the other hand, reduce the dynamics. Concentrated windings are mostly used for servo motors instead of distributed windings. By using concentrated windings, the torque can be increased. Of course, concentrated windings also have disadvantages. In the description, you can find a link to a video where I compared the different types of windings. The position sensor is usually located at the rear of the servo motor. The position sensor can be an optical, magnetic, or an inductive with a very high resolution. Because of the many magnetic poles, not only a sensor with high resolution is needed, but also a servo controller with a very fast evaluation of the sensor signal. For the control of a servo motor, a cascade controller is used. Cascade simply means that the different controllers for the position, the speed and the current are nested inside each other. This is also a standard for AC motors. As we have seen, a servo motor differs from a motor for a water pump or an electric car in small but important details. Of course, an electric car would also run with a servo motor, but the continuous performance would be very limited because of the missing water cooling. The servo motor would also be larger because the torque density is higher, but the power density is smaller. So friends, enough for today. I wish you as always a high efficiency.